Now I'm going to introduce magnetic vector potential. Magnetic vector potential is a mathematical construct that we use because it can sometimes help to simplify calculations. It doesn't really have any obvious physical significance on its own, but it is a useful tool for calculating magnetic fields, which do have physical significance. To understand where magnetic vector potential comes from, let's look again at the solenoidal law. The solenoidal law says that the divergence of B is always zero. We know there's a vector identity that says that the divergence of a curl is always zero. So let's make up a vector field A and say B is equal to the curl of A. A is the magnetic vector potential, and the solenoidal law is embedded in its definition. The other law that applies here is Ampere's law. So if we plug our new vector field A into Ampere's law, we get this equation. And another vector identity applies here, which says that the curl of a vector field equals the gradient of its divergence minus its vector Laplacian. So we get this equation. We can simplify this further by recalling Helmholtz's theorem, which says that a vector field's divergence is independent of its curl. We define the curl of A as equal to B, but if curl and divergence are independent, we don't care at all what the divergence of A is. So we can let its divergence be any arbitrary value we like. In this case, we can choose to let the divergence of A equal zero. That gets rid of this term, leaving us with only this differential equation. The solution to this differential equation is given here. A is equal to a simple integral of the current density. Again, this is pretty useless in itself, but remember, A can be used to find B. So this equation gives us a way to find the magnetic field resulting from any arbitrary current source.